Yo, Steel Mills, what's the deal, man? Yo, I'm finally off the motherfucking clock. I gotta go home. I'm not too thrilled about this little trip I gotta take, man. But I gotta go home, grab another car, because my car got overdrawn by like $60. So I ain't too thrilled about that shit. So I gotta go home, grab another car, then go to the store. But, you know, it is what it is. But Peep Game, man, we got to get into this shit, man. And that is goddamn Virgil Ortiz versus Thomas Delorme. Look, man, some shit just don't even need to be said. Some shit does not need to even be said. There is no excuse as to why Virgil Ortiz is lining it up with a Thomas Delorme, who I don't even think we've seen since he got put to sleep by goddamn Jerron Ennis. And even before Jerron Ennis, he met his doom at the hands of Terrence Bud Crawford. What the fuck are we talking about? Who else smacked on him? Was it Amontis? It was either Amontis or Jamal James. Or was it Sergey? I can't remember who it was that got in the ring and crashed him or whatever, man. But this shit is unacceptable, bro. This shit is unacceptable. I'm sorry, bro. After the last performance of Virgil Ortiz, it pisses me off because I got a lot of high hopes for Virgil Ortiz. I think Virgil Ortiz, if he's healthy, he's a factor. He's a factor, and I can see him fighting at 160. I can see him fighting at 160, man. But I just need to know that, I need to know that he could carry the weight properly, man. We got robbed his last outing because of fucking Tony Weeks prematurely jumping in, stopping the fight and all that. He just keeps doing goofy shit, yo. It's time for Tony Weeks to sit down, man. But in his last bout, he got a minute and change into the fight before it was even stopped. We didn't see if his, well, clearly his power translated, but that dude had fought as low as welterweight before. I need to see him in there with someone who's a little bit bigger and, been hit by bigger dudes than Virgil or same size as Virgil. So, but from the looks of things, it looked like his power translated. We don't know whether his power down the stretch translates, because we don't know if his stamina translates. And that's the biggest thing that we missed out on that fight a couple, some months back, with Tony Weeks prematurely stopping. We don't know if his power or not. We don't know if his stamina translates. We don't know if his dexterity and his feet translate. Because Virgil cuts angles as well, bro. He's a dude who likes to bang in the pocket. So he cuts those angles. He rips to the body. We don't know if all of that shit translated. We don't know. And we got robbed from finding out because of motherfucking Tony Weeks. And I just think that shit is a travesty, man. What the fuck are you doing, man? So you go from that to Thomas Delorme in a new division, in a bigger division that's stacked and seems to be, picking up momentum once again. This just isn't smart matchmaking, man. This is some PBC bullshit. What the fuck would make you think that Virgil Ortiz gains anything out of fighting a Thomas Delorme after this dude done got crashed by a multitude of different fighters in a smaller division? Shit, man. Bud stopped him at 140, bro. Why is he at 154 pounds looking to fight a hungry young lion? It just don't make no goddamn sense, bro. It don't make no goddamn sense
for you to bring his ass up to 154.
My bad. It don't make no sense for y'all to bring him up to 154 pounds to fight goddamn Virgil Ortiz when that's just not a smart move. It's not smart for, Thomas Delorme's health, and it's not smart for Virgil Ortiz's growth. You gain nothing out of fighting these fights. You about to go into a training camp. Thousands of crunches, thousands of push-ups, that medicine ball, close to a million punches on the mitts, the heavy bag, the speed bag, the double-end bag, dieting, watching your food, what you take into your body. You're about to put an ample amount of stress on your body. We ain't even got to get into sparring. You're about to put an ample amount of stress on your body to prepare for Thomas Delorme. It's not necessary. The ends don't justify the means. This dude isn't even a notable name. This is worse than Thurman fighting fucking Zoo. it's no profile, to, you know, that, you know, relevant profile attached to Keith Thurman. It's no relevant profile attached to goddamn Thomas Delore made. The last time folks remember seeing him was against Boots. And if he's fought since then, that's a testament to what it is that I'm saying. Fight no fucking Thomas Delore made when you Virgil Ortiz in a higher division. What the fuck for? What the fuck for? What the fuck for? Don't stunt your growth fighting something like this. Dude is a... This ain't 20... What was that? 2017? 2016? This ain't that, bro. No, 2015, I want to say. This ain't that. This ain't that. Why are you looking to fight this nigga, bro? Like, oh, you know, shame on Oscar De La Hoya. Why is he fighting Thomas Delorme? Why? Don't fight no fucking Thomas Delorme and you're looking to... No, bro. You gain nothing out of this fight, man. That's the, you know, that's the bottom line. You're about to put your body through a whole bunch of bullshit to a dude who's not going to enhance your profile at all. Not even on names. Bro, just at this point in time, because Virgil was already an established fighter, we just want to see how he looks at 154 pounds. Bro, you got to go in there with somebody who's maybe not, I wouldn't say, you know, declarated or nothing like that, or a contender. It's just about, now it's just about getting your feet wet. You dipped your toe in the last fight. You was prematurely stopped. Your mom came and stopped you before you jumped and, you know, dove in the deep end. She came and snatched you away from the pool, so you wasn't able to, you know, submerge yourself into the 154-pound division. You know, the dude, who's the dude that, the Peoria, someone of that ilk, you know what I'm saying? He's been in there, you know, been in there with Tony Harrison, man. Like, you need to fight someone like that. Someone a little bit more seasoned at the division. That's something, you need to fight somebody of that ilk, man. You can't afford, you know, this dude, you stunt your growth when you regress in competition before you peak. That's what this shit is, you know, that's what bothers me about all this, man. Like, just David Morrell fighting Andre, you stagnate yourself. You can't afford to do that when you're still, you know, your body is still growing, your boxing brain is still, configurating. You're still in a position where you can learn shit. You learn nothing but bad habits when you fight dudes who are lesser than the dudes that you fought, that you've previously fought. You picking Thomas Delorme over a motherfucking Cavaliasquez? I think not. You picking Thomas Delorme over a McKinson? I think not. No, bro. It's a pointless fight. It's a pointless fight. You gain nothing out of this fight. No experience. You don't gain no more experiences that you gain when you fought goddamn Cavaliasquez and McKesson. You gain no more experience off of that shit, bro. No more. You ain't got to put him in there with a top 10 contender, let alone, you know, a dude who's right on the cusp of title contention. We ain't got to do that. We ain't got to do that. But we don't got to do this neither, because this is unacceptable. Oscar De La Hoya is another dude who had, you know, he suffers from that as well. As much shit as I talk about the PBC, Oscar De La Hoya does some faulty matchmaking as well. Why are you doing this? Why are you doing this? Why are you doing this for Virgil Ortiz? Virgil Ortiz has the potential. He has superstar potential. The way that he fights, he's learning Spanish now. He didn't grow up speaking it, but he's learning it in the now. This kid has the potential to be a pound-for-pound talent. I've been saying this shit for years. Jerron Ennis, as of right now, ain't fucking with Virgil Ortiz. He's not. He's more active. Even if he's inactive, he's more active, bro. Virgil Ortiz fought. No. I'll take that back. Jerron Ennis fought twice last year. He fought twice last year. but you know his fire is going to, is withering away because you know why is it taking this long to get y'all fight over get a fight over the line with Cody Crowley? And from what I've been told, that fight ain't even going down no more, man. I this shit is ridiculous, man. This shit is ridiculous that's going on with him. That dude is about to. I'm not even about to go into Jaron Ennis. We back on Virgil Ortiz, bro. This fight is unnecessary. Why the fuck are you about to fight Thomas Delorme? Just no hopers, man. Oscar, what are you doing? Why are you putting the dude with so much potential in the ring with a Thomas Delorme? This late in Thomas Delorme's career, he gains nothing out of fighting Thomas Delorme. How could y'all even think that this was a bright idea? Multiple knockout losses in smaller weights, in smaller weight classes, by quality opposition, and now you want to move him up in front of a fucking killer. You can't make this shit make sense. You can't make it up, yo. You just have to understand that, yo, this is some bullshit. This is a bullshit fight. I have no interest in seeing Virgil Ortiz get in there with fucking Thomas Delorme. How dare y'all put this card on thinking that, who thought that this was a bright idea? Oscar. This passes for exceptional. This is what we doing. Thomas Delorme against Virgil Ortiz. When I heard Virgil Ortiz and Jose Ramirez were, you know, they were head, you know, they were, you know, they were on a card together. Hell yeah, bet that. That's what the fuck I like to see. Hell yeah. I'm not mad at Jose Ramirez for fighting Francis Bartholomew. That, even though he's a lot more, regressed, he still has a style that can trouble, Jose Ramirez when it, as far as, you know, punching on the go. All right, cool. Go ahead and feed him. Go ahead and feed Ramesses to him. All right, whatever the fuck ever. I can stand to see that fight, but fucking Thomas Delorme against Virgil Ortiz, they'd have been better off giving fucking Thomas Delorme to goddamn Jose Ramirez. Why is he fighting at middleweight, bro? Why is he fighting at middleweight? There's a multitude of middleweights that you can go holler at, man. A multitude of middleweights. I can't think of the only. What super middleweight or junior middleweights do we have on the zone side of the street? I'm not so sure. But at this point in time, it's time to start outsourcing. Somebody got to have a junior middleweight for fucking Virgil Ortiz, man. Who want a shot at an opportunity to usurp a fighter in Virgil Ortiz? Beat Virgil Ortiz and you're an underdog, that's headliners. There goes your career. This, you know, the jump start to the career that you need so bad. But y'all keep doing, y'all keep recycling these older, past and regressed fighters, man. Y'all keep, I don't know why, like, y'all know firsthand how dangerous of a sport that is, man. At what point do you start to, have compassion for the fighter? As a fighter, we can't put this dude in the ring with no Virgil Ortiz. We can't do that with Virgil Ortiz. We can't do that to him. Nah. You're past it. It just ain't, nah, bro. If this was another fighter, possibly I'd consider it, but this fight is just too dangerous. It's too dangerous. Virgil Ortiz punches the bro. The dude broke fucking Mo Hook's hand, bro, or broke his arm, bro. There's nothing. Hey. I'm saying, man, like, what are we doing? I'm saying, this is not no kid you want to send a old head in the fight. This ain't him. Not him, bro. Fuck is wrong with y'all? Terrible matchmaking, bro. This match, like, I don't get it with niggas, man. I don't get it with niggas. They said this dude is about to be a sacrificial lamb. Not only are we gonna put you in there with a bona fide killer, a young lion, we're gonna put you in there in a higher division. After you done got crashed in smaller divisions, 140, 47, now 54. You about to go in there and fight Virgil Ortiz, man. You just can't make sense out of this shit, man. And I really need these matchmakers and these promoters, especially if you're a former fighter, to really start coming to the realization that, yo, this shit is kind of a cruel and unusual punishment. That's the only, you know, that's the that phrase and that, you know, that word and that verbiage. That's the proper, you know, that's the proper verbiage for this action. It's cruel and unusual punishment. Long and short of it. Long and fucking short of it. We still got time. Time is the Lord made. Please just go on ahead and back up out of that fight. I would hate to really see you get fucked up in there, man. Because that's real life what's about to happen. You're about to get hurt, bro. About to get hurt, and as many times as you'd have been knocked out. I mean, that shit, bro. Jerron Ennis did not, that wasn't a shot, that shot landed on the back of the head. I don't think it was intentional, but it definitely sailed behind the, you know, behind the ear, bro. Like, well behind, and you clearly see how you feel like, yo, your balance was compromised. Jerron Ennis eventually will be at 154 pounds. That's not no dude you're trying to get smacked on by, and you got smacked on him by that dude. You got smacked on by that dude. Shots behind the head, man, those shots tend to, you know, those shots can linger. The shots that you consistently get hit with throughout the duration of your career linger as is. Your last fight, to my recollection, you got smacked on in the back of the head. And now you finna go in here and fight enough, man. You got the game fucked up, man. Shame on Oscar, Roberto Diaz, whoever decided that this was a smart matchup and a step in the right direction for Virgil Ortiz, because it isn't. Virgil Ortiz deserves better than this. He needs a fight that's gonna push him. He needs a fight that's, whatever deficiencies still exist within his game, those holes need to be filled. Super pause. But we gotta start, because now we're in a position where all the belts ain't on one side of the street. Tim Zhu has a belt. He's about to have two belts. But Madrimov has a belt, and I don't know where the third belt or the fourth belt is going to go. I don't know. But it's sprawled out now. And with Madrimov being on your side of the street, that's a potential matchup right there. That's a potential matchup right there. We could fuck around and get a DAZN versus Golden Boy type, card. The same way we finna get a Matchroom versus Queensberry card. You gain nothing out of fighting Thomas Delorme, bro. It's a waste of fucking time. Waste of time. Waste of fucking time, bro. I really don't even know what else to say about it, man. This shit is trash. I don't like it. Fuck whoever decided that this was a good idea, because, you niggas belong over there on PBC Island with this type of matchmaking, bro. It's stupid. And it stinks to high hell. So, that's pretty much all I got to say about this shit, man. Hopefully, after he goes in here and dispatches of this dude in one round, we'll get a much better fight for him that can properly prepare him. That can properly prepare him for the 154 pound division, because Thomas Delorme just ain't it, Brody. I'm done babbling right now, man. I'm at the crib. I'm about to go get this card and head to the store so I can get back home, man. Y'all stay righteous. I'll get with y'all later, y'all. Deuces.